Grant Fuhr, who's 8-10-2, mostly as a Oiler, and just the one loss of 4-3.
The bow getting in alone on Fuhr, although he's being cut off. And Fuhr stands him up. As you see, Fuhr had his hand away up the shaft of the goal stick. Here's the penalty now. I mean, there's been 10 minutes of great action, lots of hits. Looks like it's open, but it...
Gilchrist drops the glove. Petit roars in there. That all started back in the center ice zone when Bradley got dumped, and he grabbed a handful of sweater of Gilchrist, and we'll see how referee Mirowelli sorts this up. You're watching Molson Canadian.
There's a good check, but it isn't much good when you go down and the guy you hit stays up.
Well, it is
when you go into the corner, you have to contain
in front of the net with Lyle Odelaine and Deblois. And I think it was Odelaine who had a pretty good grasp on Deblois' stick.
Right on the line. And he just shoots it. It goes by Daniel, and then is tipped by Semeda. And Patrick Roy is spoiled finally by a tip in.
So the Maple Leafs tie the game. Gunnar Hamsley.
Drop pass right there. Another drop pass right here. And here's the shot. Ellett didn't have a lot of time, but he had it going in the right direction. Look at Rouse, right down by the icing line. Close to the point. And now the three blue shirts head. And it hits Swoboda. The Leafs get a whack at it right here. Does Mike Foligno. But Patrick Waugh makes a good stop. Look at the two Montreal defensemen grab the two Leafs and run a little interference to give Patrick a little longer to grab that loose puck.
Mike Foligno getting a little extra shift here with Marois on the box. What's the scoring here tonight?
It looked like a harmless rush coming over the Leaf blue line. But two little drop passes and Ferraro pulls the trigger. Here's how it started. And you can see the Leafs, they're not outnumbered. But no one takes Ferraro as both Zezel and the right defenseman, I couldn't see who it was, go to the other man.
Grant Fuhr's beat to his really gives Pakoda a ride right there into the board.
Well, this line, the fault line they call themselves, caused all kinds of havoc in the offensive zone. Not very many pretty goals, but a lot that come out of big-time efforts like this one. As Berube goes to the net, nobody takes him. And a good, solid, hustling play again by Mike Foligno.
This is Charles Langford of Perry Sound. Played by Pilon, who went for the fake shot. And then goaltender Weeks is down way too early. I don't want to take anything away from Marowal.
But a bad play by the Islander defenseman. A goalie who prematurely went down. Marowal saw it and put it up.
Ties this game at two.
Well, most of the people in the gardens were looking at Berube nearly taking Pilon's head off, and Grant might have been taking a look at that, or some of his teammates, as they waltzed out of the zone. And McElwain, as we mentioned in the opening, can really skate, and he dances by everybody, takes a little slash from Rouse, lays Grant Fuhr down and puts it in. There's another look at it. Smooth as silk. They only played less than 9 minutes, and it's four goals scored here at Maple Leaf Garden.
Basketball Mets.
Well, we know Jeff Reese is going to play tomorrow, and I'm wondering whether Tom Watt's going to put him in tonight. Although, in all fairness to Grant Fuhr, all three goals, the guy's been in pretty well alone on him. A nice pass here by Adam Creighton to King, who goes to the net. Krushelnitsky can't take him. I think it's Krushelnitsky. Can't handle him going to the net. Tom Watt from 35 yards out against the wind goes for a field goal. It hits trainer Dan Lemelin in the back. So tonight, they're not there. They're over on this side.
See how good he is.
Pilon can't handle Foligno at all in front of the net. Weeks is tap dancing in the goal. Makes the stop. And Pilon's got Foligno's stick for a second. See him? He's got a stick. Foligno can't get it loose to try and poke that rebound that he knows is sitting right there. Gill by Semeda, who was knocked down. Look at this prone pass. And watch Weeks come across. If he'd have come across standing up,
I don't think it would have been a tough stop.
Todd Gill one time did.
Here we go. Nick Pakoda and Todd Gill
Hutchurst Gill is too excited about Swan punching yet with that broken finger of his. And it looks like more he's intent on the wrestling stages here than throwing them. And Vakota's taking advantage of it.
Well, Vakota got into this fight before Gill was ready. And we know that Vakota can really throw him in this league. He's got 9 goals in his career. He got 3 of them in one game, the other 6 in the 220.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. Mike Bullard's got a very quick pair of hands, and he showed you right there how quick they were. He had to recover that puck as it was rolling wide, get it back out in front, put it in. A nice pass right there to Shannon. Now watch Bullard. Now, you think that he had lots of time, but if you're in that spot, you don't have lots of time. Here's another look at it. Bullard has to get it, control it, bring it back out and put it in.
Mike.
When the rebound comes right back to the defenseman's leg, and Grant was scrambling along and falling back into the net on the second shot. Here's the first one. Now, watch Fuhr. Gets halfway up and has to go down again to make the second. Not how hard you shoot it if you get it on the right spot. Let's have a look at this play. McGuire's got it, skates over it. Kervers just gets it on the net. I mean, he's just hoping that puck gets tipped, and it actually did hit a Maple Leaf on the way in and beat Fuhr to his left. Watch it right here. Here's the shot. There it is. Hit the defenseman.
And number 26.
And deflect into the net. A lucky goal.
12:45.
But if you put it on. Well, when you get caught for a 2-on-1 with less than 2 minutes to go in a game that you should have had put away, then this is what results. The 2-on-1, Gill was caught, and then it wasn't very well played by the defenseman to allow the pass over. You've got to take the pass away. Rouse didn't, and Ferraro just redirected it in for his fifth goal in two nights.